Tomorrow night, we are entering interesting festival. The name of the festival is Tu B'Shvat, which is the 15th day of the Jewish month of Shvat. It's a holiday also known as the New Year for Trees. The word Tu is number 15 in Hebrew, so this is really the basis of this holiday. But there's a lot behind this in Kabbalah. And it is known that Kabbalists are celebrating it in many, many deep intention. So what more we have about this month, about this holiday? Interesting gematria. The gematria of this month, which is called Shvat, come to 311, which is exactly the same numerical value gematria of the angel Raphael, very known to be the angel in charge of healing. He came to heal Abraham. Now what you see are verses from the book, it's called Zera Kodesh, from Rupshis, and he says really in short what is behind this holiday, but is much more beyond definite Kabbalah. So the gematria of the man Shvat is the same as the gematria of the angel Raphael, who is in charge of healing, as it is in the meaning of his name. Now this implies that in this month, an aspect of cure and healing for trees continues, because in this time there is a raising in the trees. This blessing and cure for the trees continues for the whole world. As we know, the Torah says a man is compared to a tree. So it is a lot behind this. And this is the main idea. A lot about it you can read in my book, The Mystical Glory of Sabbath and Festivals. There I brought, among all the other festivals with Sabbath, also about this month, what really are behind this festival, the Kabbalistic, very interesting ideas. So, one can see a lot about it in the internet if you put Tu B'Shvat, the 15th of Shvat. But I want to show you now a very interesting table. Okay, the verses are in Hebrew, but try to explain them. There are not so many verses, but very, very significant and interesting table to do with this holiday, Tu B'Shvat. So, let us see now, step by step, this table. So what we have in this table, so the first thing which is the most important is this, the name of this holiday, which is Tu B'Shvat. Tu 15 B'Shvat, yeah, as we said before. So interesting, as we saw, important holiday, and amazingly, parallel comes this year, Tavshin Pe Aleph, 5781. Yeah, like Chatam Sofer says, the verse of Me'ashpot, Tarim Evyon, Yarim Evyon, so amazing, comes here, parallel. And we said many times that parallel, and also coming in such a way, not crooked and so on, it means there is something behind. So it means there is some deep connection to the 15th of Shvat, to B'Shvat, to this year, which fits very much with what we show a lot in YouTube, that this year is very, very significant one. By the way, what also makes this table significant, it appears in few chapters in the book, in fact, really, in part of the book of Exodus and then Leviticus. So, interesting is what we see here more. So, what we see here more, also parallel to this year, Teshuvah, repentance, unbelievable, which is exactly the condition, yeah, for Messiah, who comes here also at the top, Mashiach. Interesting. So, we know also, the Maimonides, the Rambam says, that redemption Messiah will come in the merit of doing tshuva, repentance. And this year is very important one, as we saw many indications that if really we'll do tshuva, repentance, return back to keep the Sabbath and all this, and the Gentile definitely to keep the seven laws of Noach and the most important sexual matters, yeah, which brought destruction, the story of the flood, because of then it's written also that Gentiles should keep these very important commandments, no abortion, no homosexuality, man, woman, wedding. Definitely, all this against that Jews have to keep the Sabbath. But we see that Satan is still strong, disturbing to do it. But no, if you want Messiah, and you want to get out from this terrible sickness, so let us see what we have to do. Repentance, definitely. And then it is so interesting, if you followed my YouTube, you can see that all the time when we had Corona, when we have Corona, okay, here Corona, quite a big ski, but it comes, interesting, Corona, you can see. Corona comes here. So if you go into this thing, and you see the leprosy comes also, right, as Sarat, and even written in your Parnegat Sarat, the Sarat will be healed. Now, Sarat, leprosy, we said, similar to Corona, to many other things, cholera, SARS, all are from heaven to indicate that we are sinning, we are translating the Torah. Yeah. It's from God, you know. 2/3 of the Americans believe it's from God, but they should believe also that is the reason for it, that we have to do tshuva, to repent, to keep purity of life, no abortion. No abortion, we said, was the most severe sin which brought to the flood. This is why the Torah tells us that it took 40 days for the rain who brought the flood. What we need 40, 30, what difference? The Torah is very particular to give us details. But the idea is written, is God wanted to indicate to us, you caused me to create creatures, fetus, embryos. 40 days, 40 days gives already shape, meaning to this embryo, and to destroy it, so I will destroy you. Yeah, and this is why the flood came, you know, so abortion, homosexuality. And our rabbis tell us that we will not have now a flood all over the world, but we'll have flood in different places. But amazing Medrash, homiletic, says, in Song of Song, two songs, 2,000 years ago, God's written there, God says, next to the time of Messiah, God will bring a great pestilence, Deber Gadol Balalam. Now, pestilence really is a concept for all plagues, frightening, exactly, telling us that before Messiah, where we are now, this plague will come to bring us to repentance, to keep the Torah, to do tshuva, unbelievable. Now, Kabbalistically, it is very famous, apparently, that the Tu Bishvat, this festival, this holiday, has a very important goal, destiny, to rectify the Taken Tikkun, the sin of the Es Dat, the tree of knowledge. We know that because Adam ate from the tree of knowledge, transcend the command of God, and this is a reason for all the troubles we are going through, and in fact, all the process of time is to rectify the taken, so sequential rectification to the tree of knowledge. All right, amazing. This is exactly the tree of knowledge is definitely the same idea of those trees, yeah? These fruits we are eating. So eating these fruits, you know, some eat 7, something 15, all have reason, you know, we eat the different kind of fruits, we say blessing to God properly, you know, to rectify the sin of Adam eating from the tree of knowledge, Adam and Eve. Some יצרתי פוץ, כמו תוקה בלה, אבל יצרתי, לכל זה הפוץ, וישאב אשל אראון, זה הסם, הוא דונת אבנו של, אינו, אינו, סיד אינסייד, אינו, היפ אינסייד, so, this is representing Kabbalistic, the high world, the world of emanation. So these 10 fruits, one can see the, they are brought the names. So 10 fruits, which don't have shell, and we don't have pip in the fruit itself. So this is against the creation, the world of emanation in the creation. The fruits which have pop inside, yeah, are, but no shell, are against the book of creation, the world of creation. Those who have both shell around and pop inside are against this physical world. So, in fact, there are people, many Kabbalists, who had 30 kind of fruits, and there are 10 which said no peep, no shell, and shell, and peep, and peep, and no shell. Amazing. 10, 10, 10. So, lots of interesting ideas behind this, mainly Kabbalistically, which is really a rectification of the tree of knowledge, and the rectification of the tree of knowledge will bring us definitely the Messiah. Now what more we have here? We have small skip of Raphael, the angel Raphael. Yeah. He is important on healing. It's what we have in Pat Sarat. So if we do Shuvah, if we return to the Torah, if we keep the Torah, then we have the angel Raphael coming. Interesting. In Hebrew also, Raphael comes from the root Rapho, healing. Yeah. Then, what more we have here, very interesting and significant, we have here exactly a verse in the Torah, in Exodus, in Leviticus, which says the following, V'avatam et Hashem Elokechem, you should serve the Lord your God. Then, U'berach et Lachmecha, then you will bless your bread, and your water, Memecha, V'asirot imachala mikirbecha. And then I will remove sickness, the seed from your midst. Unbelievable. Et misfar yamecha amale, I will fill the days, your days. Man, you will not die young. Yeah, I will full days. But all this, if you repent, then you will be healed from the magefa. Magefa in Hebrew is a plague. Unbelievable. By the way, you have the Raphael here also. Parallel. You have twice Raphael. You have Raphael and you have parallel Raphael. So as I said, all together, really very, very interesting, significant table for our time. We need very much to be healed from this curse corona. Yeah. And we see what is going on. Not so easy to get rid of it, you see. More and more, we try to make all vaccinations. As two-thirds of Americans believe from God, so must be a reason for it. So the only way to be healed, Refuah or Raphael, is the only way by doing Shuvah repentance. So interesting and significant table in which we have really to be Shvat, 15th of Shvat, on this year, Tavshin Pei Aleph, 5781, and parallel Shvat, telling us, do repentance, and you will be healed from the plague of the corona, and you will have Messiah. Mashiach will come. So very interesting and significant table for our time.